What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're just seeing this face for the first time, hi, I'm Chinye, and this is my channel. If you already know this face from previous videos, welcome and thank you for stopping by again. Today, I am going to be a bridal fairy to a bride out there. Okay, today I'm going to be talking about weddings. I love weddings. I enjoy weddings. I just feel that it shows that two people are in love with each other, and it's the celebration of love. And the idea that two people have decided to spend forever with each other just gives me tingles, and I feel good about it. So that's why I'm going to be talking about weddings today, and most especially I'm going to be dealing with a bride-to-be today, because I used to be a bride-to-be and I know the stress involved in planning a wedding, most especially if you want to save some money by doing all the planning yourself. But if you have the funds, if you have the resources to hire a wedding planner, please go ahead and do that. It is fine, because planning a wedding can be very stressful, but you can do the planning yourself. I did the planning of my wedding myself. So in this video, I will be helping you through this journey right from the moment you got your engagement ring. Yeah, you're happy, you're fronting. Yeah, bask in the euphoria of the moment right now, because it's going to take a couple of weeks or months for reality to sink in, and then you have to start thinking about planning your wedding. All right, so let's start with you. You are the bride. You are the face of the event. Everyone wants to know what you're wearing, what your makeup looks like, and that alone is enough pressure. You want to stand out. You don't want your guests looking prettier than you on that day. Well, I don't care, but most brides want to be the talk of the day. I'm going to focus on your skin. You want your skin to glow. You want your skin to look beautiful in pictures. Yes, there are editing apps used by photographers to make the skin glow, but how confident do you even want to look on that day? So that really matters. I'll be sharing with you a smoothie that can do some magic to your skin before your big day. But you need to start taking this smoothie about maybe probably 6 months, 4 months before your wedding, and you definitely see results. And also, please stay hydrated. This is very important. You're going to be running all around looking for vendors and being disappointed. There's going to be times when you cry, get frustrated. Yeah, it is very normal to have such feelings when planning the wedding, but I'll be helping you through this, and I will leave you off this stress you're feeling right now. All right, I've been there. I used to be a bride-to-be, and I know what it takes to plan a wedding, especially if you're trying to save some money by doing all of the running around yourself. You're going to be stressed up. Really stressed up. But if you have the financial resources to hire a bridal or wedding company to handle the wedding planning, it will even be perfect. But I'm discussing right now with brides that want to plan their weddings themselves, brides that want to handle the planning themselves, and also brides that have the financial capabilities. There are some tips and points that you should also take note of. So without further ado, let's get started. Lastly, I'll be talking about your skin, and I'll be sharing with you a particular glow tonic that helps you to have a glowing skin on your big day. This glow tonic has about 7 ingredients, and 6 out of the 7 ingredients are naturally occurring fruits and spices. You will need to blend them together to create this tonic or smoothie, and you will see the results. You need to take this constantly, and definitely you will see the results. After a while, your skin will definitely look different. You will be popping. If you're naturally dark skin, oh my lord, you will look lovely. It will just glow. If you're light skin, the same thing. Everything will just be perfect. You will see that you have less blemishes, your skin looks very hydrated, and you would love how your skin looks. Alright, so spinach is the very first ingredient, then carrots, ginger, beetroot, cucumber, lemon, and the seventh ingredient is water. Blend this and turn them into a smoothie. It will eventually help your skin stay hydrated. It will help your skin glow. Trust me, this really works. If you know that you have reactions to lemon or any fruits there, you can just skip the fruit. Lemon or ginger, which I know are like the two harsh ingredients there, then you can just skip them, okay? It's still fine. So that should definitely do the trick for you. The good thing is that these ingredients combined will create a very lovely effect on your skin. So when you create a smoothie out of these fruits, it gives you a better metabolism, it boosts your metabolism, helps in weight loss, bloating, and in the long run, it helps you glow, which is my aim, all right? As a bride-to-be, you need to breathe. Take away that anxiety, throw it out of the door. It is not easy to plan a wedding. It can be very time consuming. It can be very stressful. You see yourself getting anxious, and because you don't know what to expect on that day, you don't know if you're going to be disappointed by your vendors. And people get disappointed on their wedding day and it just ruins everything, and you're worried about that. Breathe. Everything is going to be fine and everything is going to be taken care of. Now you are engaged and you want to share the news with the world. You want to share the news with your entire family, social media. Yes, some couples usually take the time to just be with each other for a while before sharing. And please note that there are some people in your life that should get the news before social media does, and it would be rude of you to skip them and just hop onto social media to share the news. Now, if you have very close friends, close relatives, your immediate family, go ahead, let them know you're engaged. Let everyone congratulate you. Firstly, celebrate within your circle, your immediate family, friends, and loved ones. Celebrate within that circle before you hop onto social media to declare your news. Now, then you can go ahead and share it on social media. You can use whatever hashtags, you can create your hashtags and then start preparing your wedding website. Yeah, some people actually do that, which is very lovely, by the way. I didn't because I was too busy. The next thing to do is to ensure that you celebrate your engagement. You enjoy the fact that you're engaged. Most times, people expect you to get married immediately after getting engaged. If that is the case for you, if that is what you want to do or you and your spouse plan to do, then fine. But if that is not the case, enjoy the fact that you're engaged. Just stay engaged for a little while and enjoy that. You know, it's just a moment that wouldn't last forever, and the next thing you know, you're married, you're a couple, you start to deal with married life. And if you have the funds to do this, you and your new fiance can hop on a plane and just travel to a city you love, a place you love, or just enjoy that moment, okay? Enjoy your engagement. You need that. The next step for you to do is to get inspiration. Once it's time to get married, you start saving all the pictures of dresses and gowns that you can find online, and you get your inspiration from that. Yes, get inspired. Go online, you know the theme of your wedding. Get inspired by other people, because sometimes you may not even know the theme you want, but when you see other weddings online, you know, okay, I want something like this, or I want a mixture of this and that. All right, so go online and get inspired. There are lots of themes out there, thousands and millions of themes out there. Just look for the one that inspires you and pick that one, the kind of dress you want, the kind of makeup you want, and just get all of that. Get organized, put all of this in your tab, and ensure that you know the kind of wedding you want to have. It does not matter if you're hosting just 10 people or a million people, it doesn't matter. Just get organized, get inspired by other people's weddings, and everything is online right now, so just go online and look for what you want. I'm sure you will definitely find one. The next thing now is to know your guest list. This can be very daunting for lots of brides, because most brides may just know about 50 people in their lifetime, and they're like, oh, I just want 50 people in my wedding. And then your mom is like, no, I have like 1,000 people in my church, I have like 1,000 people in my village, I must invite them, because these people would be angry if they find out that my daughter got married and I did not invite them. You have your mother-in-law that knows like 1,000,000 people. All of that can create chaos. That will steal the fun from this whole planning process. Know your guest list, know the number of guests you want, and stand by it. If your parents are having their own guest list, that's on them. If they want to host their own guests, like after the wedding, they can go ahead and do that. So you just have to work with a guest list. Check, know those you want to invite to your wedding, know those that you have to skip. You do not need to invite the entire village to your wedding. Let it be really intimate, let it be people who really matter to you. And then if your parents have people who matter to them, they can invite them, and that's fine. We really cannot stop our parents from going overboard in the guest list and inviting the entire world, but I think there's a way we can get through. If you know the type of parents you have, you can talk to them and just tell them to just bring it down a little, okay? The wedding party. This is the part where you have to be very stern. Everyone wants to be on your train, especially if you are the type of bride that knows 1,000,000 ladies. You would have a lot of work to do when it comes to selecting your train, your wedding party. If you are a bride like me that knows just a handful of ladies, then that's fine. That should not be hard, okay? Just pick about 3-4 of your friends. But if you know you have 1,000,000 friends, then you have to be very selective. You have to know the kind of people you want on your train. You do not want people who will be moody on your wedding day. I have seen a situation where the bridesmaid, the bridal train, was moody. It was really devastating. Like, why are you guys sad? What is making you sad? She's supposed to be your friend, and these are not hired bridesmaids. Why are you unhappy? I've seen situations like that, and you do not want that on your day. You want people who are excited for you, who are genuinely happy for you, who really want to enjoy that day as much as you are, and who want you to feel really happy on that day. So you have to get working. Filter out the friends that you know that wouldn't give you this vibe, and pick the ones that just have the kind of vibe that you have, and you want genuinely happy people on that day. Do that, and it will work all right for you. And you do not need to put the entire world on your train. You really need to be selective. When you start having more than 10 girls in the train, it starts looking weird. So I don't know, it depends on your choice. I'm not here to tell you what to do and what not to do, but just go ahead and pick a few girls that matter to you, a few girls that will make you happy on your day. A venue depends on your budget. If you know you want an open wedding and you want a garden all around you, that can be created. Lots of things can be done now. The world has changed, okay? So if you want like a fake garden, there are event centers that provide these services. You can get that. If you want a closed wedding and you want to be in a hall, please go ahead. Just work according to your budget. Make sure that you have a detailed information about everything. When I was planning my wedding, I had a Google document where I shared my husband on. Making sure that your partner is involved just helps to reduce the burden on the bride. Next point is photography and videography, which is very important because you're doing that wedding only once, but you would want to watch videos and see pictures and all of that in even 50 years to come, and that is how memories are saved. So you would have to budget for a photographer and a videographer. Flowers. As a bride-to-be, I think it's very important that you have a bouquet of flowers. They can be really pricey if you're going for the real flowers, but there are flowers out there that look like the real deal, and some of them are quite expensive, but there are some that are really affordable. If you're going to be holding a bouquet of flowers on your wedding day, please do not let them look too fake, because it is usually so obvious, okay? Just avoid certain types of flowers and some things I really don't like seeing in the hands of a bride. It just ruins everything. And if you know you have the money to get the real flowers, then go ahead and get the real flowers. They always look different and it just always makes a statement in your pictures. Live band or a DJ. I've seen a couple have a very big argument over whether they wanted a live band or a DJ to perform at their wedding. Bride wanted a DJ, the husband wanted a live band, and it became a very big issue. Live band is usually more expensive than the DJ in most cases, unless you're going for the very high-end DJs. That just depends on you, okay? If you really are into names, there are DJs that will charge you 100 times more than a live band would. So it depends on you. Just go for what suits you. And for me, I prefer DJs. I really don't know why. Picking a wedding hashtag. I have my wedding hashtag, which is really important. I go back to my wedding hashtag and that just gives me joy. I go back and I see the memories. I see pictures of friends and people who attended my wedding. Yeah, I'm not saying it is mandatory, but it is important. It's an important part of the whole wedding planning. We are in the social media age. Everything is like online. So you can even go back to your hashtag and take some pictures from there. The next is hotel accommodation for both the couple and the wedding party. Now, it is very important to have that in mind. This is your wedding party. You really want them to be available on the wedding day. So everyone, except they are not in the same town with you, everyone should be at the same location on the eve of the wedding, because you really want your wedding party complete. So you should have an accommodation already prepared for your train. Okay, something that I'm going to add is let your vendor lead you to another vendor. It just makes things really easy for you. If you have a photographer and he's not a videographer, he can lead you to a videographer that he knows. You know, these people really know each other. They network a lot, so they go to events and they meet other vendors. reduce the burden of searching. Be careful, because lots of people really want to just help their friends and they may disappoint you at the end of the day. Make sure that you're getting the best out of these vendors. Prepare for rejection. It is fine. Not everyone you invite will attend your wedding. And do not feel bad about that. A lot of people may have things to do during that time and they wouldn't just make it to your wedding. Be prepared for that. Do not get devastated if a friend misses your wedding. Sometimes it can be intentional, sometimes it can be unplanned. So just get prepared to hear, I wouldn't be able to make it. Please put that in mind. We're trying to just help you feel good on that day, so you shouldn't have any negative energy around you. You shouldn't even emit the negative energy at all. So whether your wedding is going to be a modern wedding, a traditional wedding, a classic wedding, a vintage wedding, you would have a budget. If you know that you want an open wedding, you can get rentals, you can get flowers from rental companies, and there are really affordable ones out there that will work with your plan. So everything just truly boils down to your budget. You have to have a budget. Work with that and you will not be overspending. You also have spills to take care of the home after the wedding, because that's just the one day event. There is more after that day, so you do not want to be short on cash or bankrupt because you hosted a ton of people and you wanted the internet to call your wedding the talk of the town. I'm very sure if you're doing it to please the internet, believe me that the next weekend someone else will take that spot and your wedding becomes a thing of the past. So you do not want that. If you're throwing a very lavish wedding, if you're going to shut down the entire state, you're doing that for you, not for the internet or for what people will say. Trust me, you don't want to do things for the world. You'll be disappointed. So I hope that you have been able to gather a few points from all of this. So this is where I'm going to be drawing the curtain. I hope you have a beautiful wedding, and I hope that your home is blissful and peaceful, and I will definitely see you in my next video. Bye bye.